12 rounds of boxing for the WBC Super Middleweight and Light Heavyweight Championships of the World. Introducing, in the red corner, fighting out of Potomac, Maryland, weighing in at 165 pounds, 4 wins, 1 defeat, with 24 KOs. He is the holder of 3 different world titles in 3 weight divisions. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Sugar Ray Leonard. And in the blue corner, fighting out of Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada, weighing in at 167 pounds. His professional record consists of 31 wins, 2 defeats, with 26 KOs. He is the WBC Light Heavyweight Champion of the World, Danny, the Golden Boy, Lalonde.
Richard Steele with the final instructions.
Obey my commands at all times. Shake hands, good luck.
55th title fight for Richard Steele in 16 years as a referee. The moment has arrived for Donnie Lalonde. And everyone wonders how he'll respond. Sugar Ray Leonard, one more comeback. Here they go.
And we all wonder, is it going to be one comeback too much?
Lalonde, the owner of a thunderous right hand. In the last couple of years, under the tutelage of Tommy Gallagher, he's gotten more maneuverability from his once immobile left hand. Good block by Leonard.
I can't help but wonder and think about guys like former welterweight great Jose Napoles when he tried to step up and take out Carlos Monzon. He got destroyed. How about Bob Foster when he went against Joe Frazier? He was a splinter in there. What will happen when Lalonde hits Leonard? And you better believe he will.
The Leonard movement. Can he get inside to use his quick hands?
What's going to happen when Leonard gets close and realizes he's not nearly as strong as Lalonde?
Lalonde has fought most of his fights at 172 pounds, has come down to 167. Leonard with a good right hand. Lalonde says it didn't bother me at all.
It was a good scoring shot.
But it sends a message that Leonard could get in and he can land, and he's got fast hands.
And that's exactly how I believe Leonard will fight the remainder of this fight. In and out.
Good left, quick left landed by Lalonde.
Ray had to think about that as that right hand came whizzing past his chin. Second or third time in the career of Sugar Ray Leonard, but I just sense he really doesn't like the opponent. Maybe he's just kind of psyching himself up towards that. I felt he never liked Tommy Hearns, he never liked Hagler, he never liked Roberto Duran.
I think that's strictly pre-fight hype, Randy. It's hard not to like Donnie Lalonde. He's an outstanding person, and he's standing up for a major cause that he has expounded throughout his training, and that is stopping child abuse. Quick left hook by Leonard. And Leonard mixes it up a little bit.
You can see that Leonard does not want to get close.
No. End of round one. Donnie Lalonde trying to get the nerves out of the system. Sugar Ray Leonard. Under control, Jax Morton liked it. Roy Firestone is roving around ringside. ringside. Roy?
Sam, thank you very much. We're with Jesse the Body Ventura, who just did a movie with Donnie Lalonde. What kind of an actor was it?
Well, I don't know. I really didn't see Donnie. I came in after Donnie had been there. It's called Thunderground. Should be out in February. But I'm pumped up for this fight tonight. They're just feeling each other out now. It's going to be a lot more. But remember, everybody, November 24th, the Survivor Series in the World Wrestling Federation. Then I'll be behind the mic, Roy, where I belong now.
He can only break out of his shell. Thank you, Jesse.
Thank you, Roy.
Back to ringside. Yeah.
This is the only man who was let into ringside through security because everybody wanted his autograph. Jesse, okay.
And he didn't have the press pass, and nobody wanted to stop him.
Richard Steele has to keep them apart before the bell, and here's round two. Scheduled for 12 for two world championships. Donnie Lalonde wearing insignia on his trunks, which says no excuse for child abuse.
How true it is. Both men looking for the right hand at this point. Leonard's got a cock waiting to throw it. Donnie, if he has a chance to throw anything, it's going to be the right hand.
Leonard not doing as much dancing as he did in the Hagler fight. Not using all of the ring, but content to be in the center of the ring and just peck away.
See, Donnie's starting to load up on that right. He should have been on tracking the left.
Leonard's got to look to counter that right hand to the body.
Donnie Lalonde suffered a shoulder injury years ago playing hockey. Left shoulder, he's got a pin in the shoulder. Sugar Ray Leonard said he's going to be taking shots at the shoulder. Although nothing apparently is wrong with the shoulder, it might even be stronger because of the pin in it.
He has used a new physical therapist to get more flexibility in that shoulder. Now it turns into a bit of a wrestling match.
Donnie doesn't mind it because you just have a feeling he's stronger physically than Sugar Ray Leonard.
Good right to the body by Leonard. Made Lalonde wince a little bit. Leonard not showing any flurries. Very few combinations to this point. It's been stay away from the power. The counter. Leonard has been able to reach Lalonde with a jab. And the crowd responding. End of round two. Sugar Ray Leonard sits down in another comfortable round. For the challenger, Sugar Ray Leonard coming into this fight knew very well the power of Donnie Lalonde, and he feels he knows how to defuse it.
The key for me is to hit and not get hit, to be inside but not really be there, to frustrate him. It's similar to the way I face other opponents, Hearns and Hagler in particular.
And thus far, he's done just that.
Boom, stepped in with the jab. Spot early. Very good. Right away.
Here's some nice action. Straight left hand in round number two by the Sugar Man. And another one on the point of the chin of Donnie Lalonde.
Sharp and get out. Tommy Gallagher, trigger for Donnie Lalonde, wants him to get off sooner, quicker, using the jab. Round three, scheduled for 12. For the WBC light heavyweight and super middleweight championships. Scorecard, Randy.
I gave the first two rounds to the Sugar Man, 10-9.
Me too.
He's just doing enough, I believe, to win.
They're also sampling the scorecards of some of the writers at ringside. Wally Matthews of Newsday has given Leonard the first two rounds, as has Mike Marley of the New York Post. And Bert Sugar, we can't read his first round. I think he gave both rounds to...
No, I worked with Bert long enough to know his scratch, that chicken scratch. He gave the first round to Lalonde, the second to Leonard.
I think he may have changed it on second thought. Leonard has not set out to frustrate Lalonde. What he's done has been just his tactical boxing.
That was a sharp right hand on the ear thrown by Donnie Lalonde.
No showboating from Sugar Ray Leonard?
Not yet, anyway.
Strictly business. And Leonard says no more retirements after this. He wants to fight every 4 to 6 months. He's back. He loves the spotlight, the glamour.
I said earlier, Donnie Lalonde is going to see moves he never saw before in a ring, and he's starting to see them now. Leonard's right within punching range, and then bends down and goes left and right, and Donnie cannot find the range.
Leonard has made Lalonde miss with his jab and has beaten him to the punch several times. Lalonde trying to land that right hand. Lunging at times with that right hand. It was that right hand that knocked out Eddie Davis, giving Lalonde the WBC Light Heavyweight Championship and the right hand which knocked out Leslie Stewart when he defended it.
Donnie just pointed to his shoulder.
Good solid right to the body by Leonard.
And I'm not sure what it was that he was pointing to his shoulder about. I think Leonard has shoved him away using his shoulder. And that could be very dangerous, because if you shove a guy with your arm or your shoulder, you could cut him and hurt him.
To this point, Leonard's boxing skills and experience have been the difference. Technically flawless fight by Leonard. Right hand off the top of the head by Lalonde. End of round three. Leonard smiles. Lalonde pumps the right hand.
Beautiful, Jim. Beautiful. Let's go.
Watching the action tonight is the man who saw a lot of action in the ring in the movies. Rocky is with Roy Firestone. Roy.
Sam, thank you very much. Sylvester Stallone. It looks like Lalonde is gaining in confidence a little bit.
Very much so. This is a typical, this is like a movie. This is a Hollywood fight. It seems like everything was going against the man, the tension, the pressure, the crowd, and he seems to be rising to the occasion. Leonard looks very tentative. He's nervous. He hasn't quite seen anyone like this. He underplayed this guy a little bit, and I think Lalonde is like fighting above and beyond his ability right now, and it could make for an interesting venue.
Thanks, Sly. Back to ringside.
Thanks, Roy. Out for round four. The bell has not sounded yet. Boy, these fighters, they don't want the extra rest. They're in great shape. Outstanding condition on the part of both fighters. Good right hand by Leonard. Rocks Lalonde back. And Lalonde a little disgusted with himself that he let himself get tagged. And Leonard scores with a left hand, and now the speed of Leonard is showing. Lalonde still stalking Sugar Ray. The crowd responding to every flurry of Sugar Ray Leonard.
Lalonde had been promising to put tremendous pressure on Leonard, and he's not doing it.
Too much movement on the part of Leonard. Leonard moving out of the way, ducking away from those punches, slipping. Thus far, it's been a masterful fight plan on the part of Sugar Ray Leonard. Lalonde bangs one off the chest of Leonard.
You notice how Lalonde pushed Leonard off with his shoulder. It's getting rough in there. And I think Lalonde realizes he can't physically manhandle Leonard.
And Leonard goes down. Sugar Ray Leonard is down. He's up at four. And now what will happen? How will Ray Leonard respond?
I think he's going to move. He's going to get out of there, or he's going to hold on for dear life, his boxing life.
Sugar Ray Leonard was down in the fight with Kevin Howard and came back to win. Here, Donnie Lalonde puts him down in the fourth round. Lalonde has been a great finisher whenever he's had his opponent hurt. Leonard on wobbly legs holds on. Lalonde loading up the right hand.
Well, you're going to see him do that. He's going to just wing it from every corner of the stadium.
To that point, Leonard had been having a good round. Leonard missing that right hand.
Well, at least the canvas is a soft one that he landed on.
Leonard checking to see if there was blood. He thought there might be blood coming from his nose.
Not that the corner of Sugar Ray Leonard is a weak one. It's a very strong one. But I really believe they need Angelo Dundee in there right now.
Final seconds of round four, and the knockdown by Donnie Lalonde has turned it in his favor. And there is a cut on the inside of the nose of Sugar Ray Leonard.
In round number four, for only the second time in his career, Sugar Ray Leonard goes down. Kevin Howard did it in 1984. And now this right hand, a glancing blow. It looked to catch Ray around the side of the head, and down he goes. It looks to be this. I think it was a glancing blow off the top of the head. He was more off balance than anything else.
The left. Now there's the cut on the inside of the nose. The left on the side of the head. Wobble, Sugar Ray Leonard.
It wasn't a great shot, no question about it. I think he was more of balance than anything.
Look at the left. Bang, off the side of the head. This is round five.
Leonard tasting blood for one of the very few times in his career.
Scoring on your card.
I gave that last round 10-9 to Donnie Lalonde. I would have had a 10-8, except Leonard came back, and before the knockdown was doing pretty well.
Okay, that's how I have it also. Fight even at 38-38, two rounds apiece. Checking the scorecards of our sports writer friends at ringside. Wally Matthews gave that a 10-8 round and has given the last two to Lalonde. Mike Marley scored that round for Lalonde and has given Lalonde the last two. And Bert Sugar scored the last two rounds for Lalonde. He's given him the last two.
Hand away and get it out of my face.
Good left hand by Leonard as he once again resumes using that speed. Sharp jabs by Leonard. That's what he must do if he has any chance of winning against the bigger man. Glancing left hook scores for Lalonde. Leonard got in a right hand. And Lalonde gets in his right. There's no way Leonard can trade with Lalonde.
Those body shots, those were real rib roasters. One with the right hand, one with the left hand. And we've seen plenty of Donnie Lalonde That left hand looks better than we've ever seen. It's not a great left hand, but tonight it certainly is a good, strong left hand.
If Ray Leonard is to win this fight, it's got to be using that jab. Good hand speed by Leonard, the combination, scoring. And he is frustrating Lalonde with the jab, and he landed a right hand. Overhand, right rocks Lalonde, and another one. Leonard going all out, and Lalonde is holding on. Well, maybe I was wrong about Leonard coming in with a knockout. He shook Lalonde in this round. Richard Steele regained control after the roughhouse. Good right by Leonard. A big round for Sugar Ray Leonard. Lalonde slowly back to his corner.
Here's some action from round number five. A sweeping overhand right. Rung the bell of Donnie Lalonde. Another one kept those bells ringing. Lalonde trying to bob and weave, trying to just stay out of danger. But he certainly was a bit shaken up. You see Leonard trying to wing those right hands. His best shot is the overhand right. At least it was in his days as welterweight champ. Some real solid action in there.
Sugar Ray Leonard says he's a solid 160. And he has landed some big shots. Round six. And Donnie Lalonde has felt them.
I think as long as Leonard stays on the outside and uses that hand speed, jumps in and then gets out, the fight could be his. But if he loses his concentration and drops that left hand, he's open to the right.
Lalonde blocked most of that left hook. Leonard fighting with confidence.
I think Lalonde has let the momentum go right to Sugar Ray Leonard, and he's got to take it back. He's got to take it back by applying tremendous pressure. Because I just don't think Leonard has the legs to go really moving the way he did against Marvelous Marvin Hagler about a year and a half ago.
Lalonde's biggest problem is his stationary target. He gives Leonard no side-to-side movement. He's right there for Leonard to hit. So when Leonard charges in, he's usually landing. And Leonard is tough to hit for Lalonde.
That's because Donnie's throwing what we call crooked punches. He's not throwing them down the middle. They're coming from over the top. They're coming from outside, but not down the middle.
He can go the distance easily and finish strong. Good right hand by Lalonde.
It hurt Leonard. His knees just wobbled. He's in trouble.
Leonard backs up, tries to hold on. Lalonde trying to follow up and desperately trying to land the big punches.
Desperately and amateurishly.
Trying to measure Leonard for that right hand. He has not used the left hand very effectively. Leonard follows up and lands the right hand.
Donnie is breathing hard for the first time in the fight, taking some real deep breaths.
That overhand right repeatedly.
That might have been his best overhand right of the fight. Nothing happened to Lalonde.
Another good round for Sugar Ray Leonard. End of round six. given him the last two rounds, Randy, and I've put Sugar Ray Leonard ahead 58-56.
Let's see that right hand by Donnie Lalonde. He came in, he fired the right hand. It was right before that, I believe that it was. He landed the right, and Leonard was doing everything he could to stay close and take away the right hand of Lalonde. The left hand was a feeble kind of left hand. Leonard went over the head with a left, left himself open, and the right got him. His knees went. He definitely was hurt.
And here's Leonard finishing strong.
Aside from that one shot by Sugar Ray Leonard, or by Donnie Lalonde, rather, that right hand, it really was a Sugar Ray Leonard round. He did it with his jab. He did it with a few pesky right hands. But he's got to be very careful. There he came out trying to suck a shot, went over the head with a right hand.
Round seven, scheduled for 12. It's Lalonde trying to put the pressure on. He's not been able to corner Sugar Ray Leonard and keep him pinned up against the ropes.
Leonard planting his feet, trying to get all the leverage in his 165 or whatever it is, 162-pound body.
Leonard using his smarts to get off the ropes and out of trouble.
There were reports today that Leonard, although he weighed 165, came in with some sand in his shoes, some sandbags in his pants. He never did take those pants off.
Those are more than reports. I have it on good authority.
He was doing it as a psych measure to make Donnie see that he really was a big man.
His trainer, Jenks Morton, told me he was 162.5. Our unofficial scorers at ringside. Wally Matthews of Newsday has Leonard ahead 57-56. Mike Marley of the New York Post has it even at 57. Bert Sugar of Ring Magazine, Boxing Illustrated, has it Leonard 57, Lalonde 55. I've got it 58-56 for Leonard.
So do I. 58-56, 2 points, Sugar Ray Leonard.
And Leonard keeps landing that overhand right. Good right hand lead by Leonard.
And that one stopped Donnie where he was.
Lalonde is shaking and he backs off. The right hand has been extremely effective for Leonard. Now it's Lalonde trying to measure Leonard. Again, the combination finishes with a right hand, scoring for Sugar Ray Leonard. Good left hook by Leonard. Leonard could be making a mistake, slugging it out here with Donnie Lalonde. Lalonde, the puncher, is always dangerous with that thunderous right hand. But thus far, the superior boxing skills of Sugar Ray Leonard have been the difference in this fight. An awkward Donnie Lalonde has not been able to land enough punches. And he continues to miss. And Leonard continues to land. Sugar Ray Leonard taunting Donnie Lalonde as the round ends. And another good one for Leonard.
Baby. Hey, happy. All right, look, you're waiting. You could be firing back. I got it. You could be firing back. Listen to me. And listen to me. You got to stay tight on the ropes and bip, bip. Don't look to lunge. Don't look to loop your punches. Calm down. Very nice. He's ready, baby. He's ready.
Don't try to knock him out with one right hand. You got to throw two, three punches.
Very nice round for Sugar Ray Leonard. He gave what we call a paint job to Donnie Lalonde, hitting him all over the place. Left hands, right hands, arms, body, head.
Round
round eight, scheduled for 12. Leonard was down in the fourth, but was not really hurt. There's a slight cut on the inside of the nose of Sugar Ray Leonard.
And that cut has been there since he got knocked down in the fourth round.
Good left hand by Leonard. Sends perspiration flying around the ring.
It's become a battle of left hands the last two rounds, and Leonard is winning that battle.
Sugar Ray Leonard trying to prove he can be a champion at any weight class. He's been welterweight champion, junior middleweight champion. Now he wants the super middleweight and light heavyweight titles. Good luck to the body by Lalonde, but Leonard answers. And Leonard scores the combination. And again, Lalonde backs off.
Well, Lalonde backed off, but I don't believe he was hurt by either shot.
But Leonard keeps piling up the points.
Right.
Disadvantage has landed to Jeff. Good right hands by Lalonde. Back Leonard up. And a right hand uppercut landed and a straight right, and suddenly Lalonde's right hands are finding the target. Leonard standing toe to toe.
I could just about hear Angelo Dundee from his home in Miami screaming, "Get off the ropes, kid! Get off the ropes! Move!"
Round eight. Quick combination by Leonard again. Leonard has scored in combinations. Lalonde has been one punch scoring. Leonard, looking a little tired, decides to back off or at least try to sucker Lalonde in.
You saw Vinny Pazienza try that last fight rather ineffectively. Leonard just did it as good as Ali or anybody else ever did it. He really looked tired, and he suckered Donnie right in. But who knows? This is a soft ring, a squishy ring. Not good for a guy like Sugar Ray Leonard, who likes to use the ring. He'd rather have a hard surface to bounce around on.
Good left hand at the end of the round by Sugar Ray Leonard.
Three nice left hooks. Two to the body, one to the head.
Eddie Aliano works on the cut. Jenks Morton talks from outside the ring.
Early in the round, Donnie Lalonde came in, got a right hand in, after a left hand, got another right hand, came barreling in, tried to muscle Sugar Ray Leonard around, but Leonard pushed his head down and kept him off balance. Two left hands here to the body, and then right upstairs goes Sugar Ray Leonard. Three nice shots with the left.
Roy Firestone is at ringside with a view of what's going on. Roy?
With Bo Derek. Bo, is this what you expected?
Scare me like that. He really scared me for a minute. He's gorgeous. He's fabulous.
Do you think he's in control, Ray Leonard?
He is now. I think he is. Yes, I do.
Back to ringside.
She's in control.
I just gave her a 10. I gave Leonard a 10 also for round eight.
I've given Ray Leonard the last four rounds and give him a four-point lead as we go into round nine, 78-74. This is round nine, scheduled for 12.
A bit of a swelling underneath the right eye of Sugar Ray.
It has been mostly a one-handed fight for Donnie Lalonde. He's used the left basically as a tease. It hasn't been an effective weapon for him. And it never has been in his boxing career. Good left hook by Leonard.
Lalonde had just gotten in with a sharp left hook to the body when he dropped his right hand, and Leonard got home with that left hook to the head.
Leonard's jab has been just superb. Right
is Leonard's right hand doing all the scoring. Now it's the left hand doing all the scoring. The jab and the hook.
Leonard is finding it very easy to get in with the left hand.
Lalonde landed a couple of combinations. Leonard gets tagged again. Leonard not moving. Lalonde landing. Leonard stationary. Lalonde with a chance here. A big chance. Plenty of time left in round nine.
Lalonde is
good
caught.
Right hand by Leonard. Lalonde backs off. He's hurt. Lalonde is shaken up. Leonard going for it. And down goes Donnie Lalonde. It's five. He's up at six. Lalonde is cut. He's on wobbly legs.
He's out. He's out.
Right. This could be stopped at any moment. Right hand. It's all over. It's all over. Sugar Ray Leonard wins. Show his experience and his tremendous boxing skills took over. And a rock'em sock'em ninth round. Take a look at what happened. Sugar Ray Leonard landing the right hand, wobbling Donnie Lalonde all over him. Landing with both hands. At this point, Lalonde is defenseless. Lalonde desperately trying to hold on. The left sends him down. He was up at six. And then Leonard came in to finish him off. Tremendous combinations. Lalonde is defenseless. And Richard Steele ready to step in. And again, Donnie Lalonde down. And the fight over. And another magnificent performance by Sugar Ray Leonard.
We're with Sugar Ray Leonard. Ray, you had so many incredible fights, so many challenging fights. This may have been the toughest fight in your career.
Well, I have to say, Roy, that I have to give a great deal of credit to Jose Suleiman and this committee because, see, they had said some very incredible things about Don Lalonde, as well as some boxing experts didn't particularly feel that he was worthy. That proved he was worthy, not just a knockdown, but just his competitive nature. This fight also meant a great deal to me because I dedicated this fight to Randall Robinson and Trans Africa for his undying commitment during apartheid South Africa.
Ray, I want to ask you about the fourth round. Was it more of a slip or was it a legitimate right hand?
I got a little lackadaisical. He caught me. Because, see, Donnie, because his left hand is not at its best, he's compensates for the right hand. So he timed it perfectly because I got a little lazy with it.
late in the fight, it seemed as though, if we can move over here to the monitor, it seemed as though you were gaining in confidence with him, and he was a little awkward, basically.
Well, he gives you the whole square. You know, it's not really that easy to hit because the way he faces you. But here is just an amazing of punches through. I knew one would get him because I started to hurt him to the body.
Took a good punch, didn't he, Ray?
Oh, he really did. You know, that left hook there was what I worked on throughout the gym.
Donnie Lalonde came into this fight, and a lot of people said that, you know, who's Donnie Lalonde, even though he was a light heavyweight champion. I guess, you know, you pay him a lot of respect after this fight.
One thing about it, you know, Tommy Hearns was victimized by that, by Barkley, and almost by Kitchen. I knew this guy could fight. I've seen him. Forget about who he's for. Fact of the matter is, he became a champion, Roy, and hell, he fought like a champion.
There was a guy that was sitting about 2 feet from me during the whole fight, and he is the IBF middleweight champion of the world, Michael Nunn. You want a piece of Michael Nunn right away?
Well, I'm going home, and I'm enjoying Thanksgiving, enjoy my family, enjoy Christmas. I'll think about those guys later on. I got time.
Ray Leonard, congratulations. An incredible comeback and a big victory tonight.
Thank you, Roy.
Back to ringside, gentlemen.
Thank you, Roy. Let's get the official announcement for ring announcer Chuck Hull.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time, 2 minutes, 30 seconds of the ninth round. Referee Richard Steele stops the bout. The winner by a TKO and new super middleweight and light heavyweight champion of the world, Sugar Ray Leonard.
Sugar Ray Leonard owns the spotlight again. 5 times he has won world championships. And he stuns Donnie Lalonde by taking him out in the...